for problem solvers for help. His case led investigator Jill Glavin to do months of research showing us how hard it can be to understand your own driving record.
Every time Robert Marino needs to go somewhere, he takes his past with him.
I think about it every time we get in.
Marino isn't allowed to drive. He hasn't been allowed since the 90s. So his wife is always the one behind the wheel.
I work second shift, and she has to stay up till 2 o'clock in the morning and come get me. It's hard on us. It really is. Convicted per HTV.
This is what his driving record looks like. A long list of suspensions dating back to 1992. Over the years, Marino picked up charges for failing blood tests, operating while intoxicated, and driving without a license. He went to prison more than once, and the Bureau of Motor Vehicles labeled him a habitual traffic violator.
Hope it works too.
Marino says, thanks in part to his wife, he's cleaned up his life.
Really changed my lifestyle, thanks to her, and changed my life completely around. And I'm in a better place, and after these 10 years, I've served my time.
This year marks 10 years since his last conviction that triggered a 10-year license suspension with the BMV. But when Marino tried to get his license reinstated last year, he found out his suspension actually ends in 2022.
They started it on 2012.
Since his last conviction was in 2009, Marino didn't think the numbers added up. And he says when he talked to BMV,
they just told me it was a computer glitch.
Marino called the CBS4 problem solvers for help. And after months of research, here's what I was able to find out.
It's kind of maybe a quirky area of law.
I spoke with attorney Scott DeVries, who used to work as general counsel at the BMV. He literally helped write the book on this.
I was there for 3 years, and one of the things that we did was rewrite the whole administrative code.
He's in private practice now. One of his specialties, driving records.
Yeah.
He confirmed Marino's suspicions, saying he does think the BMV entered Marino's last 10-year suspension 3 to 5 years late.
That would have been done, and he would have been eligible to get full privileges back.
I found other evidence that seems to support what DeVries believes. The BMV sent this letter to Clinton County's court clerk in 2012, saying new automated procedures found people like Marino who should have been suspended, but the suspension wasn't actually in place. So they entered his suspension in 2012. They sent an unknown number of these letters, resulting in an ACLU lawsuit. The next year, in 2013, Indiana's legislature passed a state law that says the BMV must issue a suspension within 2 years.
That's where I'm at right now.
But it's not retroactive, so that leaves Marino stuck.
That's a near 4 year of hardship on me and my wife.
I think strategically,
DeVries and the BMV both pointed to two other indefinite suspensions on Marino's record, which he'll have to clear up before he can get his license back. Bottom line, DeVries says, getting out from under a history of license suspensions isn't easy.
Once they have this track record of suspensions and their driver record's a mess, do they have the money to get an attorney to unravel this stuff?
That's the question now facing Marino, who says he wants to do the right thing. The older he and his wife get, the harder life without a license becomes.
That's in my mind every day, pretty much. It's been rough.
I did go to the BMV about this. They took a look at Marino's record and pointed out that he does have two other suspensions in addition to the one that ends in 2022. The staff told me they did not want to provide any further comment for this report. But this case really brought up, Debbie, a lot of questions to get into when someone should have a second chance to drive again.
And I understand you're going to delve into this issue a little further, is that right?
Yeah, that's right. We are actually going to look at some of the other cases that Scott DeVries has worked on. He has helped people get their licenses back after decades being unable to drive.
It's life-changing, you know, and it's not just me. It's other attorneys will say, you know, I've got not guilty on criminal cases. And the reaction is so much more subdued than getting people driving privileges back, where they'll start crying, you know, because they get their life back.
We'll also talk about the issues you have to look into here to really weigh who is safe to drive with us on the roads. And I talked to Indiana Mothers Against Drunk Driving. They think they actually have a solution to this. We'll bring you that in part two of this CBS4 Problem Solvers report.